Hi, and welcome back to the Gooligum Electronics PIC Tutorials. In this video, we'll download the tutorials and take a look at how the lessons are structured. First, let's download the lessons. Go to gooligum.com.au and click on the tutorials link. We'll be starting with the baseline lessons, so I'll add those to the cart and go check out. The baseline lessons are free to download, but you need to register first, so we'll go do that. After registering, click on the Downloads link. You'll see all the lesson files that are available for download. There are the assembly language and C lessons, of course, as well as an introduction, also known as Lesson 0, that describes the tools you'll need and some sample projects you might like to look at when you finish the tutorials. We'll go ahead and download them all. Each tutorial series, such as Baseline C, comes as a separate zip archive containing the lessons in that series, which you'll need to extract. You'll need to create a folder to keep the tutorials in. I'll call mine Tutorials, just to be original. Then, move the lessons into your Tutorials folder. Each of the zip archives you extracted contain a single top-level folder, which you should move into the top level of your Tutorials folder, as I'm doing here. Each series contains a number of lessons, each in its own folder. Each lesson folder contains all the files needed for that lesson, including all the source code, so there's no need to type any of it in, and a PDF that goes into more detail than we can cover in these videos. The lesson PDFs contain hyperlinks that, if you install the tutorials with the folder structure I showed before, we'll open other lessons that explain reference topics in more detail. If you've bought the full set of tutorials, or the Gooligum PIC training board, there are a lot of files to download, which, after you've extracted them, are organised into a lot of folders, each containing a series of lessons. Confusing, isn't it? Where to make a start? The tutorials cover different, but related families of 8-bit PICs, called baseline, mid-range, and enhanced mid-range. And for each family, there's a series of assembly language lessons and another series, which covers much the same material using C. The first question is, should you learn to program PICs in assembly language, or C, or both? Assembly language is the PIC's native instruction set. It's the lowest level you can program in a form that's readable by humans. Most assembly language instructions correspond one-to-one with the binary instructions that the PIC's CPU core is actually executing. So if you want to really understand the PIC architecture, how it's laid out in terms of memory and registers, and what restrictions that architecture imposes, to understand exactly what it can and can't do, and how it does it, you need to learn assembly language. Once you've learned assembly language, you'll probably want to move on to C for most of your programming. But sometimes, you might need to drop back into assembly language, at least for part of the program, if you need to precisely control what the PIC is doing, especially if you need exact timing. And a good assembly language programmer can, usually, still wring the most performance out of a little, resource-constrained CPU, such as an 8-bit PIC. But that's much less relevant these days than it used to be. C, on the other hand, is a higher-level language that allows you to focus more on what your program is doing, instead of the tiny implementation details that the C compiler takes care of for you. C programs are faster to write, because it's easier to express what you want the program to do. And because it's easier to read, it's also easier to maintain, to go back later and make changes. Once upon a time, it was impractical to use C on tiny microcontrollers, but these days, the C compilers do a really good job, especially if you pay for the commercial versions with full optimization. In fact, they'll often find optimizations that experienced assembly language programmers miss. In the C tutorials, we assume that you're running Microchip's XC8 compiler in free mode, where it doesn't have the optimizations enabled. But, as you'll see, it's usually still good enough. The code it generates is bigger than the corresponding assembly language programs, but if it gets too big to fit into a particular PIC, it's usually easy to replace the PIC with a bigger one, for a lot less than the cost of a commercial C compiler. Of course, that's different if you're making a product that you'll sell a million of. Then you want to use the smallest microcontrollers possible to save money on each unit. Build a million of something and it really adds up. And that makes it well worth paying for a commercial compiler. So if you really want to understand PICs at the deepest level, you should start with assembly language. Or, if you just want to get a PIC to do something, it's perfectly okay to skip assembly language and go straight to C. The next question is, which of the 8-bit PIC families to start with? The original PICs are referred to as baseline devices. They're fairly simple devices, with, as you'd expect, a few limitations. But they're still useful in situations where you don't need to do anything complicated, and you want to reduce cost as much as possible. The baseline lessons start at the very beginning, assuming you know nothing about PICs. The mid-range PIC architecture expands on the baseline architecture, adding useful features and easing some of the limitations. So the mid-range lessons skip pretty quickly through the basics, assuming you've done the baseline lessons, before covering those new features. Next, there's the enhanced mid-range PIC architecture, which, as you might expect, is an enhanced version of the mid-range architecture, with even more capabilities and fewer limitations. Now, I had a choice to make when I wrote the enhanced mid-range tutorials. Should they assume that the reader's gone through all the previous material and only focus on what's different and new? That's a big ask, though, especially when for new projects, unless you're really worried about cost, enhanced mid-range PICs will often be the right choice. There's not so much need these days to learn about the earlier baseline and mid-range PICs. So with the enhanced mid-range tutorials, I made a fresh start, assuming nothing, so that if someone only wants to learn about enhanced mid-range PICs, they can start right there and ignore all the earlier lessons. But what about people who'd already gone through the baseline and mid-range lessons? They'd find the enhanced mid-range lessons very repetitive, because the new lessons repeat a lot of the earlier material. So, for those who already know about the mid-range PIC architecture, I wrote a series of lessons called Migrating to Enhanced Mid-Range PICs. Yeah, it's a clumsy name, I know. Which only explains the new enhanced features. With all that background, we can now map some paths through these tutorials, depending on what you want to learn. To learn assembly language, it's easiest to start with baseline PICs. They have the smallest set of instructions and the simplest architecture. It's relatively easy to get your head around them, to understand what everything does. You then do the mid-range lessons, and you'll better appreciate some of the features of the mid-range architecture, understand why some things are done the way they are, having learned about baseline devices first. Finally, you'd move on to migrating to enhanced mid-range lessons, to learn about the new enhanced features. If you want to learn C in addition to assembly language, it's best to start with baseline assembly language, learn about the baseline PIC architecture and what's going on under the hood, then see how the same tasks can be performed on the same devices using C in the baseline C lessons. Then mid-range assembly language to learn about the mid-range architecture, then do the C versions of those lessons. Finally, migrating to enhanced mid-range assembly language, followed by the corresponding C lessons. That's a lot of lessons to go through, but you'll have a pretty thorough understanding by the end of it. But if you just want to build projects using reasonably capable PICs and get them up and running quickly without having to understand all the ins and outs of the underlying architecture, then you only really need to learn C, and there's no need to learn about the older baseline and mid-range PICs. If your focus is getting up and running quickly with PICs in C, you only need to go through a single series, Enhanced Mid-Range PIC C. It assumes no prior PIC knowledge, and you can safely ignore everything else. So, once you've decided which path to take, dive in and get started. See you in the various PIC programming tutorials.